I'm a huge Greg Mottola fan, and I'd seen Day Trip as his first movie and obviously loved it, and Superbad is a genius comedy, so is Adventureland and Paul. So I've been kind of following his career and hoping to work with him. And obviously I love Zach Galifianakis, and then I read the material and I thought there was something so, there was just so much comedy to be mined from a suburban couple with their proverbial noses pressed to the glass, looking at the neighbours for the life they don't have. I really loved it. It's been amazing working with Greg. Greg has, he's surpassed my greatest hopes for working with him. He's collaborative and really, really funny, and he just comes up with stuff to do. Last night we were shooting a scene in a mall, and he severed the mannequin's sort of legs so that they were at a certain height so that I could peek over the top and do a bit of slapstick. And he's just great. He does all the different types of comedy, from, deadpan to satire to, he's a legend. So, yes, okay, this is the story of a suburban couple, myself and Jeff Gaffney, Karen Gaffney, and we live in this friendly suburban, cul-de-sac, and these glamorous neighbors move in. It's a little bit like Mr. and Mrs. Smith, except if the neighbors were spies, or Rear Window. It's that kind of tone where, and then we end up becoming these action spies with them, which is hilarious because we know nothing about that world. Karen Gaffney is a stay-at-home mom, and her children have gone away to school camp, Patrick and Mikey. They're 9 and 11, and she's left in the house, and she doesn't have to do carpool, and so she starts to go a little crazy. She's been given the job of designing a urinal for her friend Meg, and then this glamorous couple moves in, and it seems to highlight all her insecurities. You know, they seem to be having sex, and she and Jeff are in a rut. They seem to have no kids, and she and Jeff are sort of bogged down in banal kid-type routines. So in wanting to be like them, they end up slipping into their world. Yeah, he can do donuts. I think what's great about what John Hamm's brought to the role is a kind of, there's an anonymity to John. He doesn't reveal much. He's quite mercurial and sort of hard to get to know, if you will. And I think that sort of quality makes that character very fascinating to, you don't really know, he's a mystery. He's an enigma, and I think that's what John Hamm brings. I think I relate to Karen because for the most part, I'm at home with my kids and my day revolves around, cooking meals and doing carpool. And for Karen, she then has these exciting neighbors move in. And so it's an excuse for her really to break out of the world that she's in. It's like me getting to do a movie. This is Karen's version of getting to do a little bit of work and have something for herself. And so she revels in the opportunity to steal spy equipment from her 10-year-old and kind of watch the neighbors day in, day out. I think all the women in the neighborhood are very intimidated by Natalie. She is, 6 feet tall. She's a gorgeous foreign supermodel. She appears that way, and she's there with her handsome husband without any children, and she's exceptionally good at many things. She has a cooking blog. She's wonderful at darts. She seems to be very different from any of the women that Karen has ever met before. Well, I think Jeff and Karen have been married for over 15 years, and they're like classic parents trying to find the time to, be intimate involves a scheduling crisis. And, they're always, doing stuff for the kids, and they don't put that time into themselves. So this is their summer. Kids have gone away to camp, and they try to get, get in touch with each other in that kind of emotional and romantic way. And through actually becoming spies, they end up finding a little bit more spice and adventure and an excitement in their marriage. honestly, I've had so much fun on this movie. I feel so blessed that Greg Mottola gave me this job. All I've ever wanted to do is work with him. He's my favorite comedy director. I think he's like Blake Edwards. I cannot believe he chose me. So I've just savored every minute. I've loved working with Zach. He's just played he's the best husband on camera you could ask for. He's so gentle and encouraging if you try a joke or you know, and they've just been so supportive. I mean, I would say that I've had a bad neighbor before. It was called my grandfather. he used to turn the hose on us whenever we visited him, literally spray me and my brothers down. We're always like, Mom, Gramps has turned the hose on us again. But rest his soul, he's no longer with us. Yeah, that was my worst neighbor experience, my grandpa.
Hey, so did you like that video? Now, I've got an interesting fact for you. Did you know that The Dark Knight made more money in its first 6 days in the US than Batman Begins made in its entire domestic run? Now, for this and more movie facts, click on more videos or click on the playlist for more trailers.